করবে নাম্বার চাই না, বাট দ্য পার্সন টু হোম হি টোল্ড টু ইন্ট্রোডিউস দ্য নাম্বার সিস্টেম দ্যাট ইজ সুইডেনবার্গ, হি টোল্ড দ্যাট নো 64 ডিজিট নাম্বার সিস্টেম, দ্যাট ইজ বেস 64 নাম্বার সিস্টেম ইজ টু বি টু রিমেম্বার বাই দ্য হিউম্যান, সো ইনস্টেড অফ 64 উই ক্যান গো ফর দ্য লেসার ডিজিট নাম্বার সিস্টেম অ্যান্ড হি সাজেস্টেড দ্যাট উই উইল ইউজ দ্য অক্টাল নাম্বার সিস্টেম. Again, other things, octal number system, I'm not going deep into that because everything is available from the net and I had also used the net. Okay? There also, the Navi says, they were using the octal number system. So in computers, when it was used, it was used by IBM computers, IBM mainframe computer. Hexadecimal number system is having the base 16. But in our decimal number system, we are having base 10. How many digits are there in decimal number system? 10. Starting from 0 to 9. But in hexadecimal number system, there are 16 digits. After, because 1, 0 means 2, again 2 digits. 1 and 0, 10. So instead of 10, 10 again, it is not the initial digit, it is again combination of 2 digits, 1 and 0. So instead of 10, after 9, that means after 9, we have used the English alphabet as the digit. 10, for 10 it is A, 11 B, 12 C, 13 D, 14 E, and last three digits is F, restriction. Okay. So whenever you will convert this the hexadecimal number systems, how many digits you are getting in binary? If you will convert the hexadecimal number to binary, how many digits you are getting in binary? While converting the hexadecimal number to its binary equivalent, how many digits you are getting? Convert the hexadecimal number to binary. Hexadecimal to binary. Four digits. Maximum is four digits. Convert 15 to binary. You will get 1111. Binary equivalent of 15 is 1111. This is a number system. Just raise your hand. How many of you know about the number system? Nobody? Nobody? In such an age, such an era where computers and mobile phones are becoming more important than any other thing in our life. Yes or no? Without computers, without mobile phone, without internet, it is very difficult to live our life, and we are getting addicted onto that for some good cause or some waste of time. God, two different things. Good and bad. I'll not tell that good cause and bad cause. I will tell that good cause is definitely for the good, and waste of time cause instead of bad cause. I am using the term waste of time. That means without any work, without using the net proper in a meaningful way, without using the mobile phone in a meaningful way, without using the computer in a meaningful way, we are just playing onto that, we are getting involved in the chatting. So that is waste of time. Understood? That is chatting, then it is waste of time. That is not bad. I am not telling that that is bad, but that is waste of time. And very frankly, if you ask me, I had developed my thinking power by playing games, but certain strategic games, not like that racing. There is, in racing games, you will not apply your brain. Simply, how fast your finger can move. But having some strategic games like Age of Empires, Age of Empires 2, there for one level, I was supposed to cross one level and up to some target. To achieve that target, it took 9 days, almost 4 to 5 hours per day. Well, at that time also, I was a teacher, so I was having the computer, school computer lab with me, and I was alone, I have no other work. After teaching, from 8 to 2, I was taking lunch, so 5-3 o'clock, again, I was there in the computer lab, working. If any other work is there, then I have to do, complete it. After that, started playing till 9 o'clock. Okay, so almost 4 to 5 hours per day I was playing, and it took about 9 days to complete one game in the Age of Empires 2. And again, I did for the next time, and next time, and next time, I have to complete it faster, having some strategies to develop that play. Because I was not having any other work, I was applying my whole time to computer games. But we have some other work. Hexadecimal numbers. Two hexadecimal digits. Because one hexadecimal digit is giving us 4 bits, that means one level. And two levels, whenever we combine two levels, it gives us the 1 byte. So two levels means 2 hexadecimal digits. Understood? So based on these number of digits, binary equivalent digits, from the existing number system, that means the hexadecimal number system, maximum number system we are using now is hexadecimal. Nowadays all the computers are working on hexadecimal number system. Basically though they are working on binary number system, but in outer world we are using the hexadecimal number system. So in hexadecimal number system, 4 bits multiplied to 16 bits, that means 2 bytes of data, then 32 bits, then 64 bits. Nowadays computers are coming with 64-bit processing system. Okay, 64-bit processing system, that means whenever we are talking about 64-bit processing, that means the processor is able to process 64 bits after that. Understood? 64-bit processing means the processor is able to process 64 bits at a time. Understood? So 64 bits, if a computer is processing 2 bits at a time, and a computer is processing 16 bits at a time, 8 bits at a time, 16 bits at a time, or 32 bits at a time, and one computer is processing at 64 bits at a time, so which computer will be faster? Definitely 64 bits, because in one go only it will solve 16 bytes of data. Wherever 8 bit processing processors, they will process only 1 byte. That means it is 16 times faster than 8 bit processor. Understood? So in this way, okay, the number of bits will be more, the number of memory addresses also we can access. Even if for RAM, random access memory, it is primary memory and the secondary memory. Understood? So if we go on to these calculations, we will have a maximum processing speed of a 64-bit processor. We will have a maximum RAM limit for a 64-bit processor, maximum physical drive access also in a 64-bit processor. Scientists find fundamental maximum limit for the processor speeds. It was posted on October 13, 2009. The maximum speed they have calculated, whatever existing technology was there at that time, okay, whatever exact technologies were there at that time, that means 15 years before, onto that, to achieve the maximum speed of a computer on the existing technology, existing number system, achieve the maximum speed of a processor with the technology that were available at that time. At that time, 32-bit processing was just introduced. Understood? At that time, 32-bit processing was just introduced. And 32-bit processing means it was not exactly 32-bit processing, it was 16 plus 16-bit processing. That means the data bus, data line, like what is data line? Okay, I am giving you one example. From all the sides you could calculate. From these nodes, I think only one line. Data bus capacity of this auditorium is 6. Similarly in the computer, the same thing. How many lines of data can travel at a time? That is called as the data bus. Understood? So, whatever in 2009, the 32-bit processing was just introduced, at that time, it was not exactly 32-bit processing. It was 16 plus 16-bit processing. So what is 16-bit processing and 16-bit processing? So after that it will start processing. Understood? So it was 32-bit processing at that time. So it was predicted that it would take around 75 years to achieve the maximum speed of the processor. And nowadays, till now, whatever speed we had achieved is how much? It is 5.5 gigahertz speed of a processor. Till now, the processor is developed with 5.5 gigahertz processing speed.
And we can go
quantum.
Okay. What is superposition?
Now coming to the computer technology.
What is superposition in computer?
A bit, an electron. An electron. Pressures of electron and axis of electron. Okay. That is 0.1. In their bit, we are calculating. So, in a quantum bit, a single electron represents both 0 and 1 at a time. That is superposition. An electron can either, an atom can be either positive or negative. Positive is 1, negative is 0. But here, the quantum itself represents both 0 and 1 at a time. So, quantum bit, not any other material. So my question, my reverse question is, why silicon is used to build processors? Why silicon is used, normally the all processors or transistors, we are using the silicon. Not taken the expansion and condenser. It requires less power. It requires less power and also the data transmission rate is faster than any other material. Okay. Silicon is there, boron is there, many other materials are there. But silicon is more stable. You know better than if you know something, then you come over and tell you. Others will get benefits from that. They are great processor is there. And coming to the next one, 16 bit address and 20 address speed. So for 64 bytes. Why can't we use a bigger number system? If can be a last digit of a hexadecimal number system, then P can also be a last digit for the 32 digit number system. And so, now coming to the fact that in the octal number system we are getting 3 digits, in hexadecimal we are getting 4 digits, and in new number system will get 5 digits. That means 1 digit extra. That means 1 digit extra for 1 digit. So there, these are the 4-5 points, not more. 1 digit equivalent to 500 digits, it gives 1 extra bit than the hexadecimal digit. Then coming to, it will give 20 digits instead of 16-bit processing. That means 4 bits extra. So in 64-bit processing, we will get actually 18-bit processing, where the present maximum speed is 64 gigahertz and the future will be 64 gigahertz in total to 16. That means after gigahertz it is terahertz, terahertz after terahertz it is then petahertz. So we can achieve up to 4 petahertz processing speed. Thank you.
human knowledge is unparalleled. His letter to Jim Charlie burned 2 months before his death, but hinted at the mysterious black leader functions. Now, over 90 years later, the last prophecy of Ramanujan is slowly revealing its tantalizing secrets, uncovering fertile realms at the very edge of the black matter of earth. Q-series, harmonic mass bands, quantum magnetic bands, ultramagnetic bands, and many...
Yeah, I'm back. Yeah, that is the question. the macro functions, that's what you have to do about these functions, and what you just asked is the main question. So for many of us working in number theory, the mathematics and Mathematics' last letter, the very last letter he wrote to Hardy, has been a mystery to us. The letter was written in 1920, and until very recently finally figured out what these math data functions are. Very technical object, but it turns out that with this understanding we've been able to prove lots of wonderful things in math physics, and probability theory. It's been incredible.
This is a math data functions and the rest of it useful today, having to back.
Well, absolutely. I like to think of the Monaghan's last prophecy as a troubletrope of math. People are even using them instead of black holes.
Black holes.
And you see, this discovery of math data functions, the discovery of this range mode, is quite a historic event for mathematics.
But mathematics was coming with math data functions today?
I don't think so. Most of the applications that I've discussed involve objects that weren't even defined until long after his death. This is all brand new stuff.
But there's a lot of related question. Many of us who work in number theory, we feel like we've been playing catch up. Mm-hmm. Every few years, we figure out a little bit more about the mystery of Lamarckian. We've learned about Dodson's rank function, and then we learned about the Clank function, and now we're beginning to learn about the Mach data functions in some more concrete, rigorous sense. And what we've now learned,
beautiful and powerful creation of human spirit. These are the beautiful words of Albert Einstein. Warm good morning to all of you. Today is a special day for the music of reason, mathematics. Mathematics was a child in the hands of great intellectual and mathematician of 20th century, Sri Srinivasa Ramanujan. He was born on this day, December 22, 1887, at Erode to Komalata Ammal and K. Srinivasa Iyengar, an accountant in Kumbakonam, Tamil Nadu. To commemorate his birthday, we celebrated Ganesh Week in our school. Today, let us all remember this great soul and his contributions to the field of mathematics. Life symbolizes knowledge. The Lord of the Knowledge Principle, or Chaitanya, who is its source, the nature of all knowledge. Hence, life is worshipped as the Lord Himself. All auspicious occasions commence with the lighting of the lamp. I request respected Principal Sir, Headmistress Ma'am, Geeta Ma'am, Sadhana Ma'am to kindly light the ceremonial lamp. And also find specially made the class file for dear principal. Thank you, children. Now we have our elegant singers of class 5, 6 and 7. children, that was really beautiful and indeed trans and a treat 2 years. Now I request our dear and honourable principal sir to share his knowledge and feelings with all of us. Sir, please.
My colleagues and dear students, today is the closing ceremony of Ganesh Week. And we are celebrating this Ganesh Week in the memory of the great mathematician Ramanujan, who came to this earth for a short period and ignited, inspired all of us and went away. And now our CBSE is giving emphasis for celebrating this birthday as Ganesh Week, basically to inspire you all to create an interest in you all for mathematics, of which it is found that the students are losing interest in mathematics, or they find it a little boring. Look, in what way mathematics is important in our day-to-day life and in every sphere of our life. Now the children sang a song. There the mathematics is involved. All your sare gama pada nisa. You see, all notes are based on mathematics. If you go for a dance practice, you have different steps and you do it rhythmically. What is involved? Mathematics. God has created us all. You have two eyes and you know the entire shape of our body is based on certain mathematics. If we do not follow the pattern of mathematics, then life will be boring. 5 fingers are there and you bring close to them, it remains in a plane. And that is how we are able to hold things. It is based on certain mathematics. You see, supposing the air conditioners are there, if they are placed with proper spacing, and if mathematically, if you calculate and you put, then it will look good. So mathematics play an important role. If you are sitting or you are in a particular pattern, again mathematics is involved. If you want to design a ship, if you want to design an airplane, if whatever, you require some mathematical calculation. And for that mathematics is very, very important in your life. And if you see to nature, they perfectly obey the laws of mathematics. If the duration of day is 24 hours, it is 24 hours only. The sun rises early in the morning at the same time, because you know the nature understands the value of mathematics and they go by a perfect mathematical principle. If this 24 hours in a day will be divided properly by you using mathematics, and you allocate proper time, what time for you will go for sleep, at what time you take food, at what time you will take your daily exercises, at what time you will do your homework, what time you will devote for what subjects, then the life will be meaningful for you and you will get your desired results in a much better way than when a child is not following the principles of mathematics. And then, when you observe nature and you see how mathematically everything is set, automatically you will take interest in mathematics. And fortunately, our country took interest in mathematics, and our great rishis, those who took maximum interest in mathematics, they were the world gurus, you can say, and for the first time they taught mathematics to the rest of the world, becoming successful in every field where they go, and they went deep inside, and then they found that all knowledge comes from the Vedas, and from the Vedas they took certain things and went to their countries and wrote certain theories of their own and told the rest of the world that we have invented. You can say Pythagoras theorem or many other theorems, but the credit was given to the Greeks. The origin, if you see, it is there in our own country. So when we had scholars like this, when we have taught the whole world why India will not remain advanced as it was before. The world is fast changing, and if we take full interest in mathematics, then we can make our life meaningful. And when you take higher studies, you can become one mathematical genius, and you can make the world much better than before. It is only when we follow the principles of mathematics and we do a lot of research work on mathematics, and if we apply mathematics in day-to-day life, then we can make our world much better than before. So, on this Ganesh week, I will say that you take sincere interest on mathematics by observing nature. Note down how nature has set mathematics in the construction of this world, and how you can make mathematics meaningful in your progress of life. At the end, I again pay tribute to the great soul of Ramanujan. Let his soul inspire all of you to take full interest in mathematics, and all of you make your life meaningful and take our country to a very great height. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your really valuable words. Dance is the art of movement of the body, usually rhythmically and to music, using prescribed or improvised steps and gestures. Indian culture is incomparable. Our art form is commendable. Let's all put our hands together for Gulmini of Class 6, who is going to perform a semi-classical dance and take us into another world of culture and tradition. Siddharth Sehgal and all rounders who will be enlightening all of us about the importance of mathematics and will be presenting the report on current work. Siddharth, please.
So, one and all present here, respected principal sir, headmistress ma'am, teachers and my dear friends, I am Siddharth and I am here to share my experience on the Ganit week. Mathematics is the purest form of science and it has played a very important role in building up a modern civilization. The study of mathematics leads to logical and analytical thinking, and its learning and teaching enables better understanding of our universe. Sri Srinivas Ramanujan was born on 22nd December, this very day, in the year 1887, was a genius mathematician and he made extraordinary contributions to mathematical analysis, fraction, infinite series and number theory. To commemorate the birth anniversary of this great mathematician and to develop interest in mathematics and its application, all CBSE schools throughout the country celebrated Ganit Week from 16 December 2014 to 22nd December 2014. Here Ganit means growing aptitude in numerical innovations and training. Our school also got the opportunity to celebrate Ganit Week. The program conducted was as this. On 16 December, a lecture on mathematics was delivered by eminent scientist and professor of NIT Rourkela, Dr. Apurva Behra. He has done his doctorate from the University of Toronto. He addressed the students of class 9 and 10 and explained them the concept of balancing numbers. On the next day, 17 December, an essay writing competition was organized for the students of class 7 and 8. A quizzing session on mathematics was held for the students of class 9 and 10 on 18 December, while on 19 December, sharing of experience on innovation by teachers and students was done. Film produced by Vigyan Prasad was shown to the students on 28 December. These films were based on the life of Mr. Ramanujan. On 22nd December, that is the last day of the Ganit Week, origami competition for class 5 and poster making competition for class 6 was organized and full of fun. The session held by Professor Atul Behra was a fascinating one. All the students learnt a lot from the eminent scholar and also enjoyed his lecture. The quizzing session conducted by the teachers for the students for class 9 and 10 was entertaining, delightful and also enhanced our mathematics problem solving ability. I can say this on part of all the students that we have really enjoyed this week a lot and will remember it all our lives. I hope I get another opportunity to witness a week like this. Thank you.
The second prize, Aparna Nanda. The third prize, Bhaskarani Pari. And the special prize was given to Deepshika Behra, class 7C. Deepshika, followed by Sakshil Mahalji. Congratulations to all the winners. And now coming to class 8, that is Avanti Kambhapadraya, first position. Anushka Hota, second prize. Anushka Hota, followed by Aishwarya Sen, who got the third position. Aishwarya Sen. Aishwarya Sen. And then comes for the special prize, Saurav Shivam. Now for the result of math quiz competition, which was held on 18th of December. So that's second, followed by Smita Das. This is a team, actually for the quiz competition. So Siddharth Sehgal, Smita Das, Siddharth Pandey and Pushkar Garg. All of them were playing in the first position. The team was fifth.
Siddharth.
For the second position.
All group.
Aditya Ranjan Barik, Aniket Pandey, Adi Sharanjan, Sharanjan Bari, Aniket Pandey, I think formula member is absent, right? Aniket Pandey. Please put your hands together for all these children. Formula member is absent, all these Sumal Devra. Sumal Devra. The third position, Sanman Mitra, Sanman Mitra, Arjun Kapoor, Arjun Kapoor, Samantha Khan is absent, now I'm calling from Pritam Malik. Pritam Malik. Varun Roy, Sheetal Acharya, Sheetal Acharya is absent, Varun Roy, Maya Gali, Maya Gali. Now for the result of the first competition which is held on Electro Day, now congratulations once again to all the members. Shirabhi Panda, second position. Shirabhi. Samantha Aditya Kanunga. Aditya Kanunga. And special prizes we have here Sushri Suman Das. Sushri Suman Das and Sandeep Jena. Aditya Kanunga. Children, please be quiet. Anand. Anjali Churasia. Anjali Churasia for the second prize. Aman Dahara, class 5C, third prize. As for the second prize, we have your Muskan Mohanty. Muskan Mohanty and Sneha Chahati. Muskan Mohanty. Sneha Chahati. And the assistant, Tilak Shobhan. Tilak. Naman Pandey, Rishika Acharya, and Devin Kumar Behra. The judgment was really very tough. And for the competition also, as a token of love, I call upon Tanisha Pati. Tanisha Pati, where are you? But all of you have done an extremely good job. A big round of applause, once again, children, to your kids. And Dr. Pranin, congratulations to all those who have participated also. Excellent job. Thank you.
Respected Principal Sir, Headmistress Ma'am, colleagues, and my dear students, it's my privilege to have been asked to extend a vote of thanks to all the dignitaries who have witnessed this Ganeshvik celebration. I would like to express our sincere thanks to our Principal Sir, the dynamic person in all academic matters, for gracing this occasion. His presence today in this occasion has immensely enhanced its importance. We are extremely grateful for your insightful address. Sir, as you said that to take full interest in mathematics, how mathematics play an important role in every field, and how nature works like mathematics in our day-to-day life has truly enlightened us. We are all inspired by your great words. I express my deep headmistress, Mrs. Grijanandi Mishra ma'am and Mrs. Geeta Mishra ma'am for their guidance to us in all our activities. I would like to extend our heartfelt thanks to our senior math teacher and introduce classes from 6 to 8, Mrs. Sabana Panda ma'am, for remaining involved in all these activities. Staff members, Mrs. Nivedita Das ma'am, Mrs. Mausumi Mohanty ma'am, Mrs. T. Uma Shankar ma'am, Mrs. T. Sandhya ma'am, Mr. Soumya Prasad Nanda sir, Mr. Rajiv Nayak sir, and all the people who have made it success. How can I further to give special thanks to Mr. Sandeep Kumar Mohanty, without whose effect the whole program would have not been a successful program. I would like to thank the logistic management who has been running around doing a lot of things, and thank you so much. Finally, the wonderful students who have turned up in such great numbers. We thank you so much for your support. Thank you all once again.
Actually, simple things are really very difficult in life to do. Okay, thank you. And now I request, humbly request all of you to stand up to pay homage to our country by singing national anthem.